Governor, we've only got about 10 minutes left with you, or 9 minutes left, and there's so many other things I wanted to talk about with you. Shifting gears into something just as serious, because you are informing millions of people every week. Your television show, when is it going to be back on the airwaves? Can you give us any a view into what some of the episodes may be about? And
Alex, right now we're just ramping up. They just got the budget approved. My son is finally, I think he'll get a paycheck next week. So that means it's actually happening, because that's how you judge in L.A. A project's happening when you get a check and it clears the bank.
Yes.
Well, he should be getting paid next week for his opening participation in the show. We'll be ramping up. We haven't pared down to what the 10 conspiracies will be, but I will tell you they are allowing me to go back after JFK. So we will be taking one trip back to the past. And we're going to unleash some probably new things on the John F. Kennedy assassination that I don't believe anybody else. And if we're successful on one of the things we do, it will completely show that it was a conspiracy and that Oswald did not act alone.
Amazing.
And that's all I'll say for now, because I don't dare go any farther.
Well, if you don't know the past, you're not going to know the future.
Exactly. And, you know, and then other things that are on the radar screen. Are you familiar with this Plum Island?
Oh, biological weapons, zoological weapons laboratory,
yeah,
off the coast of New York, where we got Lyme disease and so much more. Now they've built 36 of these in major cities.
Yeah, well, that's on the screen right now. And there's a few other good ones. And again, we're just tearing them down now. We'll probably see what happens is this. True TV will start off and they'll approve like two or three of them. So we'll go ahead and begin working on them. Then in the process of working on them, other approvals will come for the other shows.
Yeah.
And so then the staff will start ramping up for those shows also. What gets confusing in doing the shows is that sometimes we'll be doing four of them at one time.
Well, you guys aren't half-assing this either. You do a lot of research, a lot of work, a lot goes into this television show.
Well, I'll tell you, for our for our little purse-string budget that we're on, we do a hell of a job, because you know what I actually did in negotiations this year?
What?
I was already locked in for the second season, so I couldn't negotiate money at all, but I could negotiate artistically. I told my top agent at William Morris, I said, look, I said, I want it in writing that this year we'll actually get a set of clappers for when we're out on the streets. You know what clappers are now, right?
Tell me.
Well, they're those little boards you see in Hollywood.
The clickers.
Put it in front of the camera, what scene it is, blah, 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 and then they clap, and that's
yes,
the way you can separate all your shoots. Well, we were so cheap in doing this thing initially, we had to use our hands.
I remember.
Yeah, to clap. And so I told them, I said, look, the only thing I demand is that I want it in writing that we will have a clapper sent to all shoots. And it was funny because my top agent at William Morris started laughing and he said, Governor, I can assure you, I'll take it out of our end. You will have a clapper this year.
Man, I tell you, you spent so much time, 6 months of work or more, over a year making the last television program. So when will we see this air in the fall of this year?
I can't even venture a guess right now, because, again, it'll depend on how many of them they want done and in the can, and how many, and at what point are we at to finish up whatever is left before they, because once they make the decision to start airing them, I've got a feeling they're going to want to have the majority of them done so that they can air them weekly like they did last time, where 10 weeks in a row you will get a different conspiracy every week.
Well, I look forward.
So venturing, and again, I'm just spitballing here, venturing a guess, I would say the soonest we'll be on will be sometime in the fall.
Well, I look forward to seeing you again in person. You're so great, and so is your son and the whole crew. The book is American Conspiracies, available at Infowars.com and everywhere else, but we have it discounted with a free film at Infowars.com or by calling 888-253-3139. Governor Ventura, in closing, we got about 3 minutes left here. Studying the New World Order, studying the global elite, studying these shadowy organizations, what has it been like, your immersion in this, and what is your model now of who's running the world and what their agenda is?
Well, I still don't know exactly who is. You know, if you're asking me to name names, I can't do that. Even Fletcher Prouty can't do it.
No, but what their agenda is?
Well, to me, the agenda is simple, and it seems clear to me. Ever since 9/11, it's been an agenda to take away our freedoms.
And slavery.
You can leave it right at that, because
slavery.
That's the most dangerous thing I've seen that have come out of all of this crap in the last 10 years is the fact that they've suspended habeas corpus. They've literally shredded the Fourth Amendment of illegal search and seizure. Every person in America needs to understand that every phone call you make and every email you send, the government has the capability to be eavesdropping that. Now, are they doing it to all of them? Of course not. But they have the ability, and they have the assurance that they can do it, because apparently our you know what's kind of interesting, Alex, is this. I now understand why they eradicate marijuana. Do you know why I can understand that?
Why?
Because our Constitution, Bill of Rights, and the flag are all made of marijuana.
That's true.
You're damn right it's true.
All the originals are hemp.
They're all made out of marijuana. The Constitution, the Bill of Rights, and Betsy Ross's flag. And so it doesn't surprise me that they want to eradicate marijuana, because they're eradicating our Constitution, they're eradicating our Bill of Rights, and they've certainly eradicated the flag, in my opinion.
Governor, I'm going to say bye to you as soon as the show ends here in about 30 seconds, but I really want to thank you for coming on. Congratulations for doing it your way, telling the truth, not compromising, getting a number one hit TV show on your network, number four on the New York Times bestseller list for the book, and people are waking up, and we got a good chance of bringing down this New World Order, and thank God we got you on our team. God bless you, Governor.
All right. Thanks, Alex. We'll talk to you again in the spring.
Absolutely. God bless you, Jesse Ventura.